forgot to get me other monitor. One moment, please. I've got my other monitor. I'm good now. Hopefully I'm good. I don't know yet. Oh, I'm good. This is what happens when you forget to get prepared. Got advertisements. Yay! Oh, that looks good. A breakfast burrito. Darn it. Oh. Alright. Going to hell in a handbasket. I'm going to die. Oh, I'm really gonna die if I don't have my glasses on. Ooh, look at that. Glasses. I can see clearly now. My glasses are on. I'm hoping this day game doesn't get harder than Sertra. Sertra. So I had a good weekend. A decent weekend. I mean, the cat threw up. I've got a big mess to clean up, but that's today. It was mostly liquid anyway. I can see clearly now. The rain is gone. Oh, look at that. She just jumped down out of nowhere. Hey, what are you doing? I've got to check something before I go. Oh, interesting. Okay. Here we go again. So my daughter has made my graphics. I forget where I'm at. Do I go through here? Oh, yes. I go through here. I was going. She can open the gate to Hellheim. To Hella. To Dillion. I wonder if I can go back and get those other two. I can always play it again. Did I get this one?
The Northmen say that in the beginning there was nothing. Darkness.
See, I did get that.
Bitter
one.
Cold to the north, fiery hot to the south. They say the cold formed ice, which melted from the sparks from the south. The power of the darkness gave life to the dripping ice, and the first giant was born.
Oh.
And was named Emir. Well, the ice.
It looks awfully dark in there.
And the power.
So dark, it's dark, the dark. Only the dead may cross.
It is very dark. Should I stay in the light? Okay, she's moving on her own right now. I'm waiting for the awesome music by that one band to play.
Truth? Anyone?
There is no one here but me.
Not you.
Did you think that I would let you go? That you lost me back in the wilds? I will never let you go. You can't get rid of me. I am your shadow. And I will be watching when you draw your last dying gasp.
I'm not ready to die.
You will be when you see what they did to your dear beloved.
Out.
When you were in love, you left him in tears to smother your furies and banish your fears. But in darkness they came. Through stormy black seas they raided these shores. Do you still hear his screams? And now that you're home, he's so far away. They've taken his soul. To these gods you cannot pray. They can break you, but not your promise. Even death won't keep you apart. Through his darkness you will find him. In your sword still beats a heart. Fought for love unspoiled by your darkness within. You fought for your dreams. Now there's no way to win. In the head of his corpse lies the seat of his soul. So you must carry his vessel to bring him back home. Sword still beats a heart. The darkness touched you. Everyone could see it in the hollows of your eyes. A gaze averted from life. You ran from it, but brought it nearer. Led it to him. An endless suffering, worse than death. And you wanted to surrender, abandon him to find peace with the gods. No. The darkness won't allow it. So you will walk into the lair of the beast. Look it in the eye. and you will go to war. This is your mission. This is your quest. There is nothing else left.
There's the awesome music. Come on. Up together. This one's got a shield. Oh, Okay. Get a shield. Shield aren't the one to use.
Every gate you open into darkness brings another challenge.
Oh. Well, that wasn't cool.
She's injured. Not
Lord Almighty. Runes. I love runes. Don't like looking for them, but I love runes.
The journey to Helheim is never a straight one.
Oh, hey.
Each must find their own path. Align yourself.
However you come to the gold-covered bridge that leads to Hel,
wait a minute.
You may find it guarded by a giantess. She will ask your name. She will ask your lineage. She will ask your business. The Northmen tell of the warrior woman Brynhild, who leapt into fire and rode to Hel to join her slain love Sigurd, and is challenged by the giantess.
I missed. No. Oh. Open that gate. Ah. can't go back out. Heard it. That room is gone forever. Jump scene. Well, it does, but oh no, use the last clue for all rooms, just give them different names. Well, thank you. The last one is this. Why I thought it would be like this, but I think I have to be up higher. You have to excuse my hand, but dysfunctional hand. Thank you. shall try and revenge. Actually, there's red letters that pop up when I'm close, but I don't see that only appeared for that one. Gotta be here somewhere. Back up a little. No. Maybe I'll look down. The steps at a different angle. I guess I could try the steps. Didn't try those before. No, it's not the steps. none of those little red letters are coming up. Maybe I'll just go up here. Oh, okay. They wanna fall.
Hela possesses large dwelling places in Helheim.
Thank you.
Tall are her walls. High
I didn't even think about
gifts.
Going up those steps the first
the
time.
The name of her dish is hunger. Her knife is famine. On her threshold all will stumble. Her bed is called sick bed, and her bed hangings are called flames of a funeral pyre. They say she is easy to recognize. Half black and half the color of flesh. And her face menacing and grim. Oh crap.
It's
it.
Look for it.
Ta-da. Right. That was faster than the other two. Look like they might have.
it's coming.
That song again.
Is it?
It's Hella.
Yes. The source of the darkness. It's coming. This is your moment. What are you doing? You're showing weakness. You're not a warrior, you're a disgrace. The gods will punish you for this. Pick up the sword, pick it up. Fight the darkness, fight it. Get up. Get up. Get up and fight!
Oh. Well, that didn't look like it was any fun. No, that was kind of... Ooh.
Stormy seas and lost souls. She's dreamt of this before. They say dreams are visions of our memories, thoughts, and fears, as seen by our inner eye.
But what if each one of us is always dreaming, even when awake, and we only see what our inner eye creates for us?
Is this what Hell is? A world shaped by Senua's nightmares? Maybe that's why people feared seeing the world through her eyes. Because if you believe that Senua's reality is twisted, you must accept that yours might be too.
You fail the gods. You're pathetic. Rotten. Cursed. What were you thinking? Did you really think you could win? How stupid can you be? Everyone hates her. She's cursed.
The shadow hates.
Look at you. A warrior. Worthless. Weak. Pathetic. Go on. Feel sorry for yourself, because there's no one left to do that for you.
Everywhere.
You failed. What's that?
Take it. If you're too much of a coward to fight, then end the suffering. Broken and lost. Just like your sword.
Come on. There.
Ow. That looks like it would have hurt.
Why go on? When you give everything and face that which torments you, only to find that it is worse than you could have imagined. Why go on? Is it really so weak to ask this? Or are we just so afraid of the honest answer that we do not dare pose the question? Sometimes the answer lies in a memory, a feeling. A song.
It's real. It's true. It's real.
It's real.
Listen to it.
Don't give up.
Daddy.
It's not like this.
It's not real. It's real. It's a trick. Don't trust it. Maybe you're already dead.
Who are you?
Do you still believe in me, Shadow?
It's real. It's happening. Go towards it.
Okay.
Before she first met him, she was not in a good place. Just a teenager, but not like the others. Barely functioning, she rarely left the house. Her father, Zinbel, made sure of that. Only occasionally did she venture out on her own, collecting firewood and herbs. Errands out in the Orkney Plains. Was her world. Like this one. Barren. And lonely.
I should. This.
It's already disappeared. Nothing lives here, not even you. It's in your mind. You think you can see it, but it's in your mind.
There he was. The lone figure of a boy. Sword play under the shade of a tree. She remembers the first time she saw him. Her young eyes, he moved as if dancing.
He's there.
And the world danced with him.
You can see
him. Or stone.
His name is Sigmund. His father's hall was built around a great tree, and one day, Odin comes and thrusts a sword into the tree, a gift to whomever can release it. Many try, but the sword only comes out at Sigurd's touch. His brother-in-law, King Sigir, wants it, but Sigmund refuses him, so King Sigir plots revenge. He invites Sigmund and his brothers to a feast, but when they arrive, they are met with an army, not a warm welcome. King Sigir captures Sigmund and his brothers, steals his coveted sword, and readies them for execution.
True.
Death for Sigmund and his brothers seems certain. But the king's wife is Sigmund's sister, and she begs for mercy and implores the king to chain them up instead. He agrees. Not for mercy, though, but because he plans an even more cruel and lingering death. Chained to a tree in the forest that night, a she-wolf comes and devours one of Sigmund's brothers. She returns, ravenous, night after night, until only Sigmund is left. The next day, Sigmund's sister sends a servant with honey to smear on Sigmund's face. But to what end? Well, that night, when the she-wolf appears again, you'll never guess what happens.
That's it. We don't get to know what happens. I want to know what happens. Find these runes, lore stands. Somebody better tell me what happens.
Day after day, watching from afar, she mimicked him. Perfecting her own secret dance. Wishing those fleeting moments of light would stretch out to last forever.
No, it's a trick.
It's an illusion.
It's not real. But you want to believe it's real. No.
So bright.
Don't even fight. It's just deception.
How does he so effortlessly court the world in bliss? If only she could do the same. See the world through eyes anew. And dance with it. Just like he does.
There's one up here that will tell us. Okay.
What's your name?
Senua.
I haven't seen you before.
I'm not. I don't leave home much.
Oh, Zeno's daughter.
I have to go.
Wait. Who taught you to fight like that?
No one.
No one?
Well, I watched you, and...
You learnt all of that from watching me? You should become a warrior, you know.
Me?
I'm Dillian. I'm here for the warrior trials. Just come and watch. And bring your sword.
You can't put it into words. That moment when you look into the eyes of the one who's supposed to reassure you, make you feel safe. It only takes an instant. Fear swallows you before you have a chance to make sense of it. And darkness becomes a part of who you are. But her world changed the day the Northman took him from her. Senua knows that there's no going back to how things were. That there's nothing to go back to at all.
Stay still, stay quiet, hide, don't tell her.
Their gods can see into your mind. They will use this power to destroy you.
They won't stop me. I can still feel him.
Whatever's left of him, they will never let him go.
I'm not gonna let him rot here!
You're the one rotting here.
Leave me alone.
You will die here.
No!
And all your suffering will have been for nothing!
Shut up!
Looks like...
Is that you?
Uh-oh.
I'll find you, my love. I promise.
You want to believe it.
Is he
not
there?
Real?
Is he there?
You're alone in these mountains.
Is that Dillian?
Nothing lives here.
You won't survive.
You met him by the tree.
She met him by the tree.
Maybe it's a sign, the tree.
What's he trying to tell you?
He's waiting for you by the tree.
As the she-wolf licks the sweet honey from Sigmund's face, he bites the wolf's tongue. The she-wolf pulls away, but Sigmund holds on. The chains break, and he is free. After his escape, Sigmund lives like us, hidden in the forest. His enemy, King Siggeir, believing him dead, as his sister plots revenge. And for vengeance to succeed, even the great Sigmund needs help. So she sends her sons to him. But their blood is weak and corrupted, and they're put to death by Sigmund. So his sister hatches a new plan, one that is cold of heart and pure of blood.
See what I can see. Another ring. A lore stone, rather.
Sigmund's sister trades shapes with a sorceress, and in disguise, she lies with her own brother. She gives birth to a son named Sinfjotli. After a time, she sends him to the forest to Sigmund. He tests the boy and finds him strong and fearless. And so they go to take their vengeance on King Siggeir. But luck is not on their side. They're captured and Siggeir has them buried alive.
That would suck. tree. Oh. Well, this was very anticlimactic. I thought there was going to be something cool in here. I love a parade. Have you played this game? Enid? Hind? I don't know how to say your name. Ouch. Oops. My characters need tabs. Well, I wonder what's over here. This one. Yeah, she would run just a little. It's actually quite fun. I'd like it if she ran a little faster. That's about it. But then again, who needs to run like Sonic the Hedgehog? Oh, this one? Yeah. That one? This one. Mm-hmm. Oh, this one. Okay. Probably will be though, maybe. It will probably be when I get my bucket. Go up and look at these rooms. Find them. Yeah. Oh, I see a ladder. I didn't see it before.
Death for Sigmund and his brother seems certain.
Oh.
But the king's wife is Sigmund's sister, and she begs for mercy and implores the king to chain them up instead. He agrees. Not for mercy, though, but because he plans an even more cruel and lingering death. Chained to a tree in the forest that night, a she-wolf comes and devours one of Sigmund's brothers. She returns, ravenous, night after night, until only Sigmund is left. The next day, Sigmund's sister sends a serpent with honey to smear on Sigmund's face. But to what end? Well, that night, when the she-wolf appears again, you'll never guess what happens.
something to do with those poor knobbies. I haven't seen that on other doors. We did not.
As Sigmund and Sinfjotli are being buried alive, Sigmund's sister throws an armful of straw into the grave mound. Hidden in the straw is Sigmund's sword, the gift of Odin. They cut their way out of the grave mound and set fire to Sigir's hall. The king burns to death. Sigmund calls to his sister to come out so that she may live and be honored. She does come out, but only to tell him the truth. That she had slept with him, her brother, to beget a strong avenger. I am not fit to live, she says, and walks back into the fire. Strike vengeance from your heart, Senua, as there is always a heavy price to pay.
Hydrate, you say? Okay, I shall hydrate. I shall drink my water. I love me some water. I think there's got to be something in that tree.
Take it. A sword. Take it.
Oh.
Take it out of you.
It's
take
a sword.
It.
Answering the trials of Odin, one for each shard.
the roots of the tree of death will take you to new lands where you will face the trials. Forced the dwarves to make a sword that would never fail and never rust, and that would slice through iron and stone and bring victory to its bearer. But the angry dwarves cursed it. It would be the death of a man every time it was drawn, and it would be the death of the king. Let me tell you about the sword Tyrving.
I don't recognize this place. Where are we? Where is she?
It feels wrong. Where are we now? Burial mound. So strange that we go to such lengths to bury death. Something so very ordinary. Inevitable.
Okay.
It's as if we conspire to hide death. Because we have no answer for it. But when it comes and forces itself onto our friends or loved ones, then comes the reckoning.
Dead in the earth, you can feel dead.
Senua, you remind me of a story that the Northmen tell about a young woman warrior. Her name is Hervor, the daughter of a berserker born after he was killed. She's a wild, willful child who teaches herself to fight with weapons. When she learns where her father is buried, her only desire is to reclaim the treasure buried with him, but above all, the sword, Tyrving.
Getting somewhere. Okay. So, I'm gonna go. That was a dead end. Run a little faster. Get a little hedgehog. Come out yet. Looking around. Over here. Missing a lore stone. Missing a few lore stones at this point. Okay. In we go. Yeah, I don't want to drown. Oh.
Who's there?
Oh, I don't like that sound. Can this be like Skyrim? Can I loot the chest?
Dillian, I'm here. I'm here for the trials. Like when we first met, remember?
What are the odds if I step on that? Something's gonna come crashing down on my head. Like in the... Hello?
Where's he gone?
How did you let him go again?
You let him leave.
He disappeared again.
How could you? I didn't let him.
You have to find him. This is your mission.
There he is.
There he is.
Dillian.
There he is.
Finally.
You found him. What's wrong? What happened? Can you hear me? Just wait there. I'll find you.
Childs. I'm ready. Oh. The fire in. How do we start these trials? I'm ready. Yeah, I'm hoping there'll be clues too. That's the only thing about this. It's like, not really that. I mean, don't get me wrong, I like my game. It's just it needs clues as to what to do. Look, I'm standing on it. Oh, I lit the fire. Now what? Can't go that way. Can I set something else on fire? No? Whoa. I don't like that sound a bit. Okay, do I go back outside? Ground on fire? Loot the treasure boxes. Or just go back outside. Okay. I beat the trials. I set the torch on fire. I win. Yay! I hope all the trials are that easy. She can't run with this thing. Come on. Put it out so we can run. Yes, indeed, I'm walking. To where I think I need to be. Walking. Okay. So I go this way. If the water will put the torch out. Yeah, probably not. What fun is that? I want to be at least jogging was a little faster than walking. Don't forget to use your channel points.
Hawaii.
Okay, there's more stuff over here. We can go look. Maybe there's another lore stone. Half a mind to get the cheat sheet out and find out what to do. Already looked at that one. Really? Run, woman, run. Cave anywhere near here besides up there. Maybe if I go back in the cave, there'll be a monster there waiting for me. Rawr. I'll win again. Set him on fire. Set you up. You look like you would be a man. But you're not. Now my leg hurts. Sorry, I apparently there are six tribes. All right, I'm going in. My ears are ringing. What happened to my fire? Well, there's a sword on it. What do I do? How about we just burn everything down? Turned around. Hmm. going to try this. Although nothing really opened, so I don't know. Oh.
I'll find him.
Oh. This is the direction we're supposed to go.
What's that? Did you hear that? Nothing. Was that voices?
Is that his voice or the voice of the dead?
Not Dillian.
Dillian's calling to you. Can
Where
you hear
is
him?
I lost him.
Hervor disguises herself as a man to join a band of warriors, and soon becomes their leader. When they come to the island where her father is buried, her men do not want to go ashore. They say that evil haunts the island, and that it is a worse place by day than other places are by night. Fearless. She lands alone. There are many grave mounds, and all of them have ghostly flames burning over them. She comes to the grave mound of her father after passing through these ghostly fires as though they were mist. The flames I passed through were real enough. Damn the Northmen to hell.
Guess we're going the other way. I'm getting it. Yeah, those blocks. Okay, I guess we're going this way.
Don't touch the wolves.
You don't know what they might do.
Turn back.
She has to keep going.
It's not safe here.
She has to keep going.
If you go down there, no one can save you.
It's too scary.
Another way. It's not working.
You have to use your mind. Where can you go?
You're failing. Find
think.
Another way.
Think.
Focus.
Use your mind.
Where's he gone? He's disappeared.
Look.
You let him slip through your fingers. I can hear him.
Within the burial mound, Hervor calls on her father to wake from death and bring her his sword. She says that it is not seemly for the dead in their grave mounds to bear valuable weapons. Her father answers with words of warning. You go to your doom. Baleful runes surround you. You have gone mad. You have lost your mind. Your thoughts are confused. It is dangerous to wake the dead. Like I said, she reminds me of you.
The voice is getting louder. Listen.
Dillian. Listen. It's him. Listen.
It's getting louder.
There he is.
You're getting close.
Keep going.
Senua, follow the voice.
You're nearly there.
Dillian's voice.
It's him. He's going to save you.
Find the voice.
Find him.
Go this way. Oh. Maybe we should have gone this way. Yeah, it is. It's like a flipping maze. Nowhere to light the...
Don't recognize it. Don't doubt yourself. You'll never find it. She doesn't recognize it. Yes, you do. You know where you are. She doesn't. Listen for his voice. Listen.
Dillian, where
listen
are you?
Listen for his voice.
Dillian.
She can't hear.
Crud.
That voice doesn't sound like Dillian.
What's happening? It's not him. It can't be.
What's that sound? The voice is changing.
What? That's not Dillian.
That doesn't sound like Dillian.
It sounds like something more dangerous.
Something is here. Something is in the labyrinth with you.
Something evil.
Hervor ignores her father's warnings. The grave mound opens, and it seems to be full of fire. Again, Hervor demands her inheritance, but her father warns her the sword is cursed and would be the bane of her family. Mm. But he relents and brings her the sword. She leaves the island with it, but the curse holds true, and death would follow in the years to come. And so, Senua, the misdeeds of a father have cursed his daughter.
Oh my. It was a lore stone in that other lit room. I'm supposed to go this way.
I'm lost without him.
That don't look right. That don't look right at all. I think all the torches are lit. So I'm gonna go back this way and go to the red room.
Where are we?
She has no idea.
We're going round in circles. You have fallen in. You think that sound is Dillian's voice? It's a trap. Does everything look the same?
It looks the same. Something's different.
Look for clues.
What is it?
What's different?
There's a clue. Look. Let her think.
No.
No, don't think in space. She just
no, no, no.
Think, don't listen to them.
Just think.
Us. She needs us to help her.
Think clearly. What do you need to do?
She needs us. Do you need to tell her what to
hole
do?
Hole in the wall.
Strategy.
Oh, God.
She needs to think. She needs to think.
She needs to think.
Think. Shh. Give her space.
Nothing you can do. Nothing.
Come on. I know you're here somewhere. Senua, find the freaking thing again. Chair. So maybe fiery glow. Might be the other way. Don't freak me out. That does not have a light. Okay, I am backwards. I somehow lost the red eerie door. And if she would run, or at least jog, it would be nice. Hey, not long, change them up. Open that door. Or don't. Excuse me for the yawns. This way. Red creepy door should be here somewhere. Creepy door. Wait a minute. Oh, goodness gracious. Goodness gracious, great balls of fire. I've even lost a chair now. No. Every time I go that way, I get a circle. I know that freaking wall was here somewhere. Freak out, we haven't gotten to it yet. And all my torches are lit. Just gotta find the wall with the hole in it. Is this the wall with the hole in it? What? That better not be. But I think it is. It is. Ain't nothing gonna break my pride. Oh no, I've got to keep a walking. Hole in the wall, I know you're here somewhere. You're on the left side. I'm not going to the right, I'm going to the left. Because that's where the hole in the wall is. Dillion, make your voice louder. Then we go to the right. I want to scream. Is that the hole in the wall? No, that ain't the hole in the wall. I can't even find the throne that I saw earlier. Don't do it. Brain, just down. Oh, her ponytail's got the shakes. Watch this. Watch. I know what's gonna happen if I look. Okay, well, I knew it. I knew that freaking one was gonna be there. Why does this game have to torture me so? Don't forget, y'all get channel points. You can use them. Tell me to hydrate and stretch. I'll stretch, I really will. You can't see it, but I will do it. My kneecaps. What's vibrating? Oh, her hair is vibrating. Yeah, I know. It's like, ugh. I think her hair's more scared than she is. Oh! Oh, crap. I thought I found the hole in the wall. No. There really is a hole in the wall, I swear. I crawled through it once. Well, I crawled through it twice, and now I can't find it. Okay. I wish I could find the beginning. What's that? I would start, I think, maybe this is the beginning. The beginning. Don't go into an unlit room. Ow. You go right. And you're supposed to go right again, but there's a gate there. Now, see, this is why I say this game is messing with me. It's like, go right. Dillian needs to stop with the screaming. He doesn't even have a head. She's carrying it on her butt. To the unlit rooms. It'll scare you out your mind. Is that the hole in the wall? Tell me that's the hole in the wall. No, see what I mean? It's the same freaking room. I think she's not going crazy. I'm going crazy. Yeah, I know. I don't know how to get out of this circle rotation. It's like, if I knew where I started, I could do the pattern that I did and get out of... You know what? I'm going left. Wait, that's still a circle of rotation. I'm not going right. I'm going left. I'm going to find the hole in the wall. There was a throne. Kind of a throne. In one of these rooms. And then the next room had a hole in the wall. That's it. I'm just throwing myself off a cliff when I get out of here. Restart this little adventure. And you can't tell which one you started from. They all have the same freaking designs in each freaking room. Focus on everything. Ah. Focus. Okay. Okay, I'm going to the room with the lore stone. I'm sorry, I pulled up a cheat sheet. I'm not gonna lie. I need to get out of this freaking Groundhog Day experience. Oh look, the lore stone. Well, this doesn't tell me nothing. Backtrack to the room with the broken wall. I've been doing that for what, 20 minutes? Or more? Maybe if I go in the opposite direction. Is getting louder. There's the throne. That's the throne. Okay. The broken wall should be here somewhere. Oh, is it over here? I hate this game. Okay, now that I'm under the broken wall, I should find the door. Not that door. Where's that? Scary door. Where are you? Sort of.
Delian wants me to face my fears.
Thank you for drawing. I did it. I walked in circles for
Father.
20 to 30 minutes.
I'm leaving. I've decided. I think it will be good for me.
It's the darkness. It's speaking through.
No, Dad, it's me. I think I can beat it in my own way.
I can see the darkness in your eyes, child.
I met a boy.
Boy?
The chief said,
thank
no.
you.
He said he could help me.
It's a trick.
He said I could be normal.
Normal?
Yes.
No boy is going to save you. No one can.
Rude.
When they see the rot growing
no.
inside you,
no.
they will turn their back on you. The gods can only fix you through my hand. You're going nowhere.
No.
You will not defy the gods. Come, child, take my hand. Come, Senua.
No! I am leaving!
You cannot escape the darkness. Your curse will make everyone suffer. You will have blood on your hands!
All right. Well, that was fun.
It's done. You did it, but there's more. Gary. There's more. You're tired, but you have to keep going. There's still more. There's always more to do. It's not going to be easy. You're hitting time.
All right. Those voices. They're so negative. What we're gonna do now, because I've only got 40 minutes. What we're gonna do, what I'm gonna do, is go ahead and end it here and turn the rest of the trials, do the rest of the trials on Wednesday. Go back to the gate. I've got to get the rest of the shards, unfortunately, which one of them is down there, then there's two. There's a total of 5 or 6 trials that I've got to do before I can get through that gate. So, yeah. So I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and end it here. Like I said, I have 40 minutes, and I've got to get some other stuff. I got to sadly, I gotta get done concerning my channel. So I will be back on Wednesday, and we will pick up the trials where we left off. We will start the next one, and hopefully I will get them all done. So I'm going to raid out, and I give me a second. Decide what I want to do. Okay. So, if y'all don't mind. Yes, Wednesday will be when I pick up doing this again. I can't tomorrow because I have family over. Normally I have family over on Wednesdays. I mean Tuesdays. Sorry, not Wednesdays. So I am going to go ahead and da-da-da-da-da. Why does this thing keep telling me that I am offline? I am not offline. You can hear me. Everybody can hear me. I'm assuming. So we are going to raid out, and I hope you all have a good evening. I hope to see you on Wednesday. And I know her hair stopped vibrating. It's finally like, hey, I'm safe now. So yeah. I hope you all have a good evening. Stay safe. And come back and see me. I love having you here. Peace out and have a good night.